Thank you and welcome to the show this morning. The topic this morning is the country of Iran from revolution to nuclear ambition. And of course, we have with us to talk about the situation in Iran today, Dr. Leonard Madu. Dr. Madu is an international lawyer, and he has been with us on a number of occasions talking about issues dealing with the Middle East as well as Africa. And of course, Dr. Madu, let me welcome you to the show this morning.
Yeah.
And let me sort of explain my hesitation in reference to that, because I was almost talking about an earlier show that we did. But this is about Iran, and this is from the revolution to the nuclear ambition of Iran. And let's have you to start us off, Dr. Madu, by saying something about the country of Iran, exactly where it's located and how it happened to be Iran from where it is now.
Yes. First of all, thank you for, you know, bringing me back to your program. Always a pleasure to be here. Iran, of course, most people know, is in the Middle East, you know, almost the size of Alaska, maybe a little smaller, maybe a little larger, but it's almost the size of Alaska in area, you know, and with a population of about 70 million at the moment, as an estimate. Has borders, you know, with several countries. Iraq has borders with Turkmenistan. Has borders with the former, you know, Soviet Azerbaijan. Has borders with Pakistan. Has borders with Afghanistan. So it's a country that's in the midst of all of these countries that are very restive. So you can understand, you know, what the problem is. And population wise, you know, it's made up of distinct ethnic and linguistic groups. The largest, you know, being Persian, which is about 51% of the population. Then you have the Azeris. Those from Azerbaijan are called the Azeris. They're about 26% of the population. Then you have the Kurds, the same Kurds you have in Iraq, the same Kurds you have in Syria. They're about 7%. Then you have the Assyrians, Georgians, Arabs, you know, making up the rest of the population. Religion wise, it's a country of about 98% Muslim. You know, out of these, you have about 89% Shiite Muslims, then 9% Sunni Muslims, and then you have Christians, Baha'is, Jews, Zoroastrians, and this made up the remaining 2%, you know, of the population of the country, you know. So looking at, you know, the overall population and language and, you know, religion, you see that this is a country, you know, that is not as homogeneous as some people might think. And this has been a source of some problems, you know, for the country over a long period of time. You know, politically, you know, the Shah was there until 1979, you know, when he was overthrown in a revolution.
This is the revolution in Iran.
Exactly, yes. The Shah was the absolute ruler of Iran until he was toppled, you know, in 1979 by a popular revolution led by the clerics, you know, in Iran. And what has happened was, prior to that time, you know, 79, you know, the Shah was perceived by the religious establishment in Iran and other Iranians, you know, are selling out to the West because of his rapid modernization of the country. Before his overthrow, you had almost 500,000 Iranian students in the United States, you know, studying and going back. So a whole lot of Iranians felt uncomfortable that the U.S. was quietly taking over control of the country. Of course, we call the Shah the policeman of the Middle East at that time, you know, with the biggest army and, you know, Navy, Air Force, and the entire, you know, Middle East. So here comes the revolution in 79, inspired by, you know, the clerics. By that I mean the Shiite clerics in
Dr.
Iran.
Dr. Let me stop for this first commercial break. I want to stop here because we want to pick up at that revolution when we come back. But the information that you're giving us now in reference to the ethnic layout of Iran sort of is made to create, in a real sense, a real problem. And of course, we'll be back with our audience following this very, very short commercial break.